Okay, so today we're going to continue working with parallel lines. So when you think about your first quiz, have you thought about or come up with a plan on what you'd write for a brain dump? Maybe it's some of the vocab. One of the things I would encourage you to write is something like this. So let's draw two parallel lines cut by a transversal. And I'm going to use X's and O's to represent those angles that are congruent. Okay? And you could use this as a guide. So this angle right here is congruent to this angle right here. Those are vertical angles, of course. And whatever you see on the top part, you can put down point of intersection. Those two angles would be congruent, which includes your alternate interior corresponding and alternate exterior. And then add some X's. You can do whatever you want. So these angles that are left are also congruent. Okay, any X and an O, are they going to be congruent? They're going to be supplementary, so let's make that note. So obviously O's are equal, X's are equal, and then X plus O equals 180 degrees. Okay, so that's just a little reference for parallel lines cut by a transversal. They can only be congruent or supplementary. Okay? Now, you can't ever modify an existing picture. So if you scan in examples 1, 2, and 3, we're given some parallel lines and then some other lines drawn, and we have to find some of the angles within those pictures. Okay? We can't change those pictures, but we can add lines to those pictures. And the lines are called auxiliary lines. Okay? Later on, when we use it in a proof, we don't refer to it by name. We refer to the parallel line postulate, which says that through any point that's not on a line, so if we start with line AB, this was in the reading, and then a point that's off the line, you can only draw one line through that point that's parallel. Okay? Any other line you draw is not going to be parallel. Okay? There's only one distinct, so let's note that that's parallel. So take a minute to look at example number one. We need to find angle W. Given that those two vertical lines are parallel and we have those other two lines drawn. So how can we find angle W by adding a line to the picture? So I'm going to grab the line tool, draw a line. I can rotate the line any way I want, but I need to add a line to that picture that will allow me to find other angles. What do you think? Yeah, Davis? Yep, we're through angle W. So right now it's intersecting angle W. So we don't know it bisects, but you want it to go through the vertex for vocab? So right through this point right here, that's right. Okay, whoops, I wanted the pen tool. So we want it to go right through vertex W. Now I don't know that it bisects it, okay? I just know that it's gonna divide it into two angles. How, again, we don't know. I'm gonna call each angle just so that when I question you guys, you know which angle I'm referring to. So I'm gonna call one angle X, the other Y. And what do we know about X and Y? Yeah. Yep, X is equal to 41. I was just looking for it to start, though, that simply X plus Y equals W. So once I find them both, the sum of the parts equals the whole. And yes, you are right. So in looking at these two parallel lines, and what I want to do that I didn't do so that I don't have to write a let statement or write anything down that I drew the line, we're just going to put an arrow here to note that we added the line so that it's parallel. We don't want to write let line, name it, intersect, angle W at vertex, P, label all that so that it's parallel. We're just going to draw and note that it's parallel with the arrow. And then, yeah, looking at this transversal, we have alternate interior. So if that angle is 41 degrees, this angle is 41 degrees. And then if we look at the other transversal, we have another set of alternate interior angles. So Y is equal to 35. So I'm going to draw the arc and use the two dashed lines and then this is 35 degrees. So therefore, W is equal to 41 plus 35, which is a sum of 76. Good. So 76 degrees equals the measure of angle W. Questions? All right, take a look at example two. Just start by adding your line. Where would you draw the line to find the measure of Z or the value of Z? Oops. So we want to have it so that it's also parallel, but it's got to go through the point or the vertex of angle Z. Make sure you do add, make sure you do add the arrow to note that it is parallel to the other two. And which angle pairs are we going to use this time? I'll break it up again so you can tell me. We'll call this X and Y, and then X plus Y equals Z. Who can tell me the value of X or Y using one of our angle pairs? Yeah, Davis? X is not 22. Oh, okay, yep. So if this angle here is 22, you can slide it right along the transversal and it's going to land right here to its corresponding angle of 22 degrees. So Y is 22 and then X is equal to 33. So take this angle, slide it down that transversal, and this is 33 degrees. You could also use this angle here and say, well, its vertical angle is 22. And then once you use that vertical angle, then the alternate terry angle is congruent. So there's many different ways to do it. So we've got 20, or actually my X is 33. 33 plus 22 is 55 degrees equals Z. All right, last one. This one's a little bit different. So all the math that I showed is a justification. The last one we have to explain. So I'm actually going to draw a T-chart or draw a line so that each statement that I write is provided with a reason. I like to bullet. So let's add our line. It's going to go right through the vertex of angle G. And let's call this, X, Y. Can anyone tell me the value of X or Y here? One of them's a new angle pair we haven't used. But you want, which one's 36? X. Good, John. So X is 36 degrees because those are same side interior. So then Y, what's the measure of angle Y? 56. So Y is actually congruent to this angle here because those are alternate interior. So the sum of 56 and 36 All right, so we did all that without explaining. So what I would suggest that you do is as you found, so the first angle that John found was X. So, and also labeling it X, that is I'm telling the person who's reading my work and grading it, say for the regents, what I'm finding. And why is X 36? Well, I didn't know, but we have two parallel lines cut by a transversal. So if two parallel lines are cut, well actually, didn't both angles have to do with the fact that they're parallel? So let's not do the bullet right there, because then I'm going to have to write that twice. So I'm actually, in two, I'm going to number this, okay? Both of these angles I found were because of parallel lines. So rather than writing it out twice, I'm just going to start by, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, one, X is 36 because same side interior angles are supplementary. And then two, Y was equal to 56 because alternate interior angles are congruent because of this premise. And then last, we did G equals 36 plus 56, which was 92. And I'm just going to simply state always, not angle addition, but the sum of the parts equals the whole. Okay. So our statements and reasons for proofs dealing with parallel lines. This is the longest reason for each one. So if you take a look at, if you do have a highlighter, go ahead and highlight the first, we'll do it in pink, the first four over here. Because they all start with, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal. They have the same premise. So if that happens, what are four things that you know or can conclude? If you're given two parallel lines cut by a transversal, what do you know to be true? Notice I have the blanks filled in. So what types of angles? We have three different types that are congruent. What are the three? Yeah. So the only numbers in this picture would be 4 and 5. So angle 4 congruent to angle 5. So alternate interior angles are congruent. What else do you know? What's another pair of congruent angles? We have to know the vocab. Besides alternate interior, what about alternate exterior? So that'd be something like 1 and 2. So angle 1 congruent to angle 2. And one last angle pair that's congruent. Besides alternate interior and alternate exterior. It begins with a C. Yeah. Corresponding. So there's actually two pair in the picture, so we'll list them both. So angle 1 congruent to angle 4, and then 2 congruent to 5. The last blank, which type of angles are supplementary in that picture? What numbers? Yeah. Three and, well, they are. But three and five would be supplementary no matter if you, or not you had parallel lines, right? So because of the parallel line piece, which ones are supplementary? Yeah. Nope. So 1 and 3, they are supplementary, but do you need parallel lines for that to happen? No, just like 3 and 5. So any linear pair is going to be supplementary. So we want to know because of the parallel lines, Jordan. Nope. 5 and 4 are alternate interior angles, which are congruent. Nope. 4 and 2, why are 4 and 2 congruent? They are... vertical. Davis. Well, that's true because 2 is congruent to 5. I'm just looking for 3 and 4, the two that are there. So angle 3 and angle 4 are supplementary because of the parallel lines. What's their name? They're on the same or different side of the transversal. Same, and in the, so let's label this. This is the interior, and this is the exterior. So they are same side interior angles. Okay. Now scan the next box of four. What do you notice? Is the if two parallel lines cut by a transversal, is that the premise? Or is it the conclusion that talks about lines being parallel? Let's use yellow. then these four, we're going to fill in the blank. Then the lines are, you can put the parallel. The lines are parallel is what goes there. So the parallel symbol is the two vertical lines. So I changed the order in which I gave, in the first four, I said to start, you had parallel lines. Now, then you have parallel lines. Now it's not my premise, but the conclusion. Okay? So because of what happens up front, now they're parallel. When you switch the if then, do you guys see how I switch the if then? That means it's a converse. And that's an old term, it's from the old curriculum, but they still use it sometimes. And I used to use the fact that, was anyone wearing Converse sneakers? Yeah, so Converse sneakers. So let's write here on the side. Think of, again, you switch the if-then statements, so and you have to switch your feet to walk, so that was something a teacher said at one point. Okay, so Converse, we're changing the order. All right, so I'm going to give you four things on the side. The first thing I'm going to tell you to start is that angle 4 is congruent to angle 1. So if I tell you that those two angles are congruent, what can you tell me, or what can you conclude about the two lines? Yeah, which two lines are parallel? M and N. So if I tell you that 4 is congruent to 1, you can say, okay, the lines must be parallel, because it only happens. So notice the word parallel is not in front of the line. So it says if two lines are cut by a transversal, we can say two form, or just in form congruent. What type of angles are 1 and 4? Did someone say that? Corresponding, yep. If corresponding angles are congruent, the lines are parallel. If I tell you that the second one, if I tell you that angle 4 is congruent to angle 5, these two angles right here, then we know the lines are parallel. Because if two lines cut by a transversal form congruent alternate interior angles, then the lines are parallel. There's one more angle pair that I could tell you is congruent, and that would be angle 1 congruent to angle 2, because those are alternate exterior. Okay? And then lastly, if I told you that angle 3 and angle 4 are supplementary, we know that M is parallel to N. Because if two lines cut by a transversal form supplementary same side interior angles, then the lines are parallel. Okay, what about the next row? What can you conclude if A is parallel to B and B is parallel to C? Yeah, Maddie? C is parallel to A. Yep. That's not the substitution, because a substitution property says you replace an angle or a segment with its congruent. It's because if two lines are parallel to the same line, then they must be parallel to each other. And then lastly, if you're told that C or BE, so ray BE bisects angle ABC, what does an angle bisector do? Yep, we say, so then we can conclude angle 1 congruent to angle 2, and we say that it divides an angle into. Now, the reason why I don't say it cuts it in half did I say anything over here about anything being cut in half? So your reason's based on what you wrote here. So I'm just going to say that it divides an angle in two. What I stated here is that I had two congruent angles. So an angle bisector divides an angle into two congruent angles. So you speak in this column about what you wrote there. So I'm going to give you a minute. If you're watching the video, pause, because for every proof, I want you to go through it yourself to make a plan, to get an idea of step-by-step how to do it, and then we'll go over it together. To remind you of the format, you always write down the givens first. If it's paragraph form, you write the whole paragraph. If it's just a couple of phrases here, like this one, then we just write the phrases. So we're going to write step number one. Angle one is congruent to angle three. And I, every time you write it, I would mark it. So that's a strategy. And then second, CE is given that it bisects angle DCB. So here's angle DCB with the bisector. So take a minute to come up with a plan or sketch it in your head, and then we'll fill it in together. So unpause it when you're ready. So one of the strategies, or another strategy with proofs, is you take a look at each given. So this given right here, angle one congruent to angle three. Can you form a conclusion or state something else that's true because of that? One congruent to three, which is highlighted in orange. Not just yet, but the other one, can you state something that's true if CE bisects DCB? Which angles are congruent? 4 and 3. So angle 4 is congruent to angle 3 because of the reason on the previous page. So if you open it up side by side, and your reasons have to be written just written as you see in that paper, or else you won't get full credit. So an angle bisector divides an angle into two congruent angles. Good. Now, if you look at what you have on the left side. So I look at all of this now. Because of all that, can I now make a conclusion? It has to do with the statements with the congruent angles. So if one is congruent to three, and four is also congruent to three, by substitution, that was a property from last class. So using the substitution property, which two angles are congruent? Yes, one and four, because they're congruent to the same angle. Or you can say, well, down here where the three is, I'm going to replace it with a one because that's its congruent angle. So now, because of one being congruent to three and four being congruent to three, we have one congruent to angle four, which is what Maddie, we were just talking about. So now that one is congruent to four, we can finish. So this is always our last statement. So number four, we are done. CE is parallel to line AB. Do I want to start with if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, or finish with then the lines are parallel? Yes, because that was my conclusion. So number four would be if two lines cut by a transversal form congruent. What's the name of the angle pair for one and four? One and four are... begins with a C. No? Corresponding. If they form congruent corresponding angles, then the lines are parallel. Okay? We're going to practice a proof like this in the classwork. It is not the same one. Okay, it is slightly different, so make sure you watch out. Other kids were just copying down what was in the notes. It's not the same one. But before we finish the notes, we're going to take a look at some theorems that have to do with perpendicularity and then a construction. So let's start with the upper box in this table. If you're told that BAC is a right angle, that's what the box means, then what does that tell you? What can you conclude? If that's a right angle, yeah. That's equal to 90 degrees, yeah, but we're stating what a right angle is, right? That's not something different, yeah. They do intersect. They have to be drawn how, though, if they intersect to form a 90-degree angle? Perpendicular. So, and because it's not a line drawn, I'm going to state ray AB, remember from unit 1, a ray is named by its endpoint, is perpendicular to ray AC. Let's move to the right. So I switched it. Here's the converse. If I start with perpendicular lines, then I have four angle 1, 2, 3, and 4 are right angles. So we can put the box in for all four. Okay? So if you have right angles, you can conclude you have perpendicular lines. If you have perpendicular lines, then you conclude you have right angles. The one below it, so we have L perpendicular to M. That's what the box means. Then, so if it's, and then we also have M parallel to N, but if L is perpendicular to M and the lines are parallel, then L must also be perpendicular to N because corresponding angles are congruent. So if a line is perpendicular to one of two parallel lines, then it is perpendicular to the other line as well. Okay? And then over here, if I want to conclude the lines are perpendicular, and we're going to state something else. Yes, I must have right angles. But another way to say you have right angles is if line G and H form a congruent pair, or I'm sorry, let's say a congruent, because 1 and 2 are a linear pair of angles. If they're congruent and they add up to 180, then their measures have to be what? 90. So that would conclude the lines are perpendicular. And then last, if two lines are perpendicular to the same line, so M is perpendicular to P and N is perpendicular to P, what must be true about M and N? They have to be parallel. Then they are parallel to each other. All right, so two quick examples with algebra and then the construction. So go ahead and read and highlight number 5. Let's see if you could set it up and then we'll solve. So I just highlighted, so work shown could be the arrows for parallel and then the box for a 90-degree angle. If I have to find X and Y, am I going to have to set up a system here or can we avoid it? Okay, so let's start with, what's the measure of this angle? So 5X plus 4Y equals 90 degrees. And then what's the measure of this angle? It's also 90, because if these are parallel and this is a right angle, then this is a right angle, and the supplement of a right angle is a right angle. So now that we have an equation with one variable, divide by 6 and y is 15, and then over here we'll plug in or substitute 15 for y, and 4 times 15 is 60, subtract the 60, we have 5x equals 30, divide by 5, and x is 6. Okay, last one before the construction. Can we avoid a system here? Well, with this one, if we have this line right here perpendicular to this one, and this line perpendicular to this one, what must be true? Say I call this line P and line Q. What must be true about lines P and Q? They're parallel. If they're both perpendicular to the same line, they're parallel. So then I'm going to highlight this transversal. Because along the green transversal, there's no angle measures labeled. Okay? So we're going to use the properties of parallel lines. And if this angle's X, I'm going to write it right here at its corresponding angle. So that's also X. I know that now X plus 2Y adds up to 180 degrees. What's another relationship you know to be true? As long as one of your angles comes from the parallel lines cut by a transversal, you're fine. Yeah, what do you know? Yes, right here. So he's taking this angle and sliding it down to its corresponding angle, and that's 2y. So we know that x plus y equals 2y, and that's good because what does that equation tell us about x and y? X is equal to y when we subtract. Okay, so then over here, do you want to replace the x with a y or replace the y with an x? Okay, so I'm going to say now y plus 2y equals 180. And then we have 3y equals 180, divide 180 by 3, and we get y is 60. Well, x has to be the same as y, so if y is 60, then x is also 60. Good. Nice job. All right, last one for today. Parallel line construction. Again, this is the only one we've done so far, so if there is a construction on your quiz, it's going to be this one right here. Okay? So we're going to be given a point not on a line. Okay, and we have to draw a line through that point that's parallel, and not just draw, construct it. Okay, so the first step is to draw a transversal. Don't draw the transversal so that it intersects at a 90 degree angle. Let's all draw the transversal so that it goes from A through P. Same. So from A through P. Can I move that? Yeah. There we go. Does everyone have the transversal? I find it's easier to use the corresponding angles postulate. So what that means is I'm going to copy this angle whose vertex is right here at A up to vertex P. Okay? So I'm going to use corresponding angles. So if I want to copy an angle, this is from unit one, you take and put the compass point at the vertex of the angle you want to copy. I'm going to bring this in a little bit. And then we draw an arc. That arc, I like putting in the dots. That's something that I didn't used to do in previous years, but I like to add them in. I think it helps you guys see the next step. Now, without changing your compass setting, now take your compass point and take it up to vertex P. And you're going to draw the same size arc on the same side of the transversal because corresponding angles are congruent. Oops, let's do that in red. Okay. See how it's matching up so far? Now, I'm going to highlight in color the points that are corresponding. So right now, this one corresponds to this one. This one in orange corresponds to this one. So I'm missing up top the point that corresponds with that one. How do I get that point? So right now the blues match up, the orange match up. I need this point up here. Does anyone have an idea? Yeah. Well, yep, we're going to take our compass. So let's switch that to purple. And we need to measure this distance right here. So slide this up. And we make an arc to show that we measured the distance between those two points with the tool. And then see how right now that compass point's on the orange? You slide it up to the orange point above. And then you're going to make that same mark or arc. Okay, you can put your compass down. Now through that point of intersection right there, I leave it as black. Now you can draw a line through that point connecting it to P. So I'll get out the line tool. You see how mine's just slightly off to the right, the one I use the line tool. But you could always, just as a little trick, go back over your points with a dot that's just bigger to make it look like it went exactly through your point. Just a little trick. Okay, last step, go back up. We had to construct CD, so I'm going to label this point C and then this point D. And now that line CD is parallel to AB.